was at home again beside the stream. Then you walk past me.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. It is Wednesday. That means that it is Walt Disney Wednesday. And if you guys don't know what a cricket is, check out all my playlists because I got like ridiculous amounts of videos for you guys. And if you guys don't have one and you want one, check out my link because there's the latest coupon codes, as well as if you're buying any products, check out that link first always because I'm gonna always have those coupon codes ready for you guys to save some moolah. All right, today we are making trendy Mickey Mouse shoes. We are gonna be making these. They are super, super totes adorbs, and I'm too old to say that, but they are, so I feel like I can say it. Okay, so let's get going. If you guys don't have a Cricut, check out that link. Let's go. All right, guys, so we are gonna start by thinking up an idea, and I will show you how I created this image after this tutorial in an Illustrator / Photoshop tutorial. So I did all that work, and then I cut it out onto my vinyl, and then I sat and weeded it. This is one of those projects that will be one of those projects you want to sit in front of a movie because there's a lot of weeding to it, but it's really fun. And Landis actually wanted to do one of these for herself, so I thought that this would be a really fun craft for kids to help out on, and they can make themselves some custom fun shoes. And then once I had the whole project weeded, I got some blank Faded Glory shoes from Walmart that were like $5. And then I took my design and made sure that it was all finished being weeded, and then I separated it from any other things that I had it connected to, like the next tutorial I might be doing, but you'll have to wait for that one. So then I just positioned it over my shoes and tried to figure out where I wanted it. I thought it would be fun to put Mickey on one side and then the bottom of his body on the other shoe. So I just kind of figured out where it would cover the entire shoe and then stuck it on top of the canvas, and then I just kind of tacked it down in one little spot. You can kind of trim up where you know it's not going to be needed, just to give yourself some more like spots to hold on to it. But I'm just going to pop the iron right onto like one little spot so that it stays on there and I don't have to worry about it coming off while I go around and cut all the extras off. So I'm gonna stick that on there, and then I'm gonna push the rest of the design down and cut around the soles and all the little sewing spots that I don't want it to go over. And then I'm gonna go over it with my iron. You'll notice I'm not using any barrier for this. I'm just being really careful not to melt it, and I'm just using the very tip of my iron. I'm also being careful when I go around the bottom of the shoes because the rubber will melt, so be careful. So just make sure that you let it cool completely before you pull off the plastic, and then you can go ahead and pull your plastic off. And there may be some little spots on the ends that you want to trim up after, so just make sure you get in there real good. And then I took the rest of the designs that weren't on the main part of the shoe and I just kind of collaged them onto the back by doing the same thing. I tacked it on in one little spot, and then I just went slowly around all the little edges and cut off the pieces that I didn't need. And then you can use the extra little pieces that you're cutting off for other little projects, or you can just toss them, but that's a lot of weeding work, so you might want to save those for something else. And then once we get that nice and trimmed up and fitting around the shoe, you'll go around the back and make sure that it's nice and fitted to the back and all that. You iron it on, and then they look like this when they're all done. I'll be putting a tutorial up on how I made this graphic on how to turn JPEGs into SVGs coming up soon.